this on the hip like this, this way back. Because they're not worried about getting hit. They always kind of keep this here. You know? So ring, Voxman saying ring, they keep it high. When you see them in the classic, they keep it on the hip. Do you see it? Okay? All right. So just a couple of things. So let's just, you can do this chambering, arming they call it, you can do that. Just be careful, it's just, you know, I didn't do it in the beginning because again, I'm just trying to be sort of like lazy. But if you do Voxman say street sabat, you want to be able to chamber because pow, you can hit with that toe. That toe is brutal. Especially if you have the boots on, you start hitting with that toe, it really, really hurts, okay? So yesterday we did foot ba. We did foot medium. Foot medium. Right? Foot figure. Foot figure is the high. Just want to stick to the low a little bit just so we can kind of maneuver with this stuff, okay? So this is what we're gonna do. Look. Very, very simple stuff. Kuta Pipa, it's just low. But I want to show a different couple of styles, what they show. The direct Kuta Pipa is in the front, and it's like a break, traditionally. You're supposed to scrape it on the floor. So if you see my body, I'm supposed to break it and then let it go. Do you see it? So it's supposed to act as a break for a scrape and then launch it like a slingshot. And it's supposed to give that good reaction. Really what makes it powerful, boom, is the opposing force, is my head going back. This best works on attacks, but it's best when it works on defense. And that's why I tend to see a lot of MMA, but Holly Holm started to look like this. She started to look, the oblique kick, that's where it came from, all right? So when he throws the cross, boom, he goes well. You can attack it, but you gotta be really careful. So I don't like to attack it with a direct. I like to do the lateral attack. I like to get on the outside and do it, or the interior and do it. I don't like to direct because I'm in front of his guard all the time. All right? So I want you to learn to do this. When he throws across, or the front, doesn't matter, frontal area or jab or cross, whatever you want to call it, right? Frontal, okay? When he punches, with a punch or cross, punch, that exposes that. Punch, punch. But you still want to keep your guard up, your front hand, so punch. See it? Punch. Doesn't matter. Just make sure you have your hand up. But the key is when you go back. Feel it? So it just turns your body a little bit?
Yeah.
So when he turns his body, you see it? What did it expose? Cross. Boom. You gotta be careful with that heel, okay? Just be real careful. So look, one, when you exchange, see it? I get, there you go. So you do it. That still parries, but that push the same dip, okay? So that dip exposes that. That's where, bang, you would chasse. Or you could be on the kidney, okay? The deadly one is this one. I'm gonna be easy. Be easy. Don't worry. See the knee buckle?
Yeah. I got the rest on.
I'm good. No, I'm good. You're good. See it? One. See it? See it buckle? Okay? So I'm just showing you a couple versions. See it? And then the other last would be the foot there. See it? Right there. Lateral movement. Lateral means.